Hello, in this class we will discuss the part 2 of register transfer and micro operation. There are 4 types of micro operations. One is register transfer micro operation, which we have explained in the part 1. 2 is the arithmetic micro operations. 3 is the logic micro operation, which deals with the bit manipulations. 4 is the shift micro operation, which also deals with the bit manipulation. Now all of you know the basic arithmetic operation, which are addition, subtraction, increment, decrement. So here in this case you can see this is how we can represent those things in a register transfer language. Here in the first instruction R1 plus R2 we will add them up, and after that we will copy the content of the addition into the R3 register. So this is how we represent the addition in register transfer language. Similarly, the subtraction operation can be implemented with the help of 2's complement. Here, the 2's complement of R2 is R2 complement plus 1. If we add them up with the R1 register content, we will get the overall subtraction result. And after that, we can copy that content into the R3 register. And this is how, in register transfer language, we represent the subtraction operation. Similarly, other arithmetic operations are also there, like 1's complement you can achieve just by, you can represent just by putting a bar over R2. Similarly, you can represent 2's complement, increment or decrement in a register transfer language. Now, I need to explain what is half adder. Half adder is precisely used for 1-bit addition. So let us consider that x and y are 2 1-bit variables. Then the truth table of the half adder will look like this. So here you can know, you know that if x is 0 and y is 0, then sum is 0, carry is 0. Similarly for 0 1, carry 0, sum 1. For 1 0, carry 0, sum 1. But for 1 1, there will be a carry where sum will be 0. Now if we design this truth table in a Carnot map, then we will get the following equation corresponding to the output carry and sum. And here you can see that carry is nothing else but the AND operation between X and Y input, whereas sum is a XOR operation between the input X and Y. So if we design this thing in a digital circuit, then it will be designed like this. Here you can see that with the help of this digital circuit, we can implement the half adder in real hardware architecture. Similarly, full adder is used for n-bit addition. So this is the truth table of a full adder. Here we just not consider only the input variables, here we also consider the previously generated carry by the previous bit position. And here you can see that if you add a x0 and y0, it will generate the carry 0 and sum 0. And similarly, when in the next iteration, when we will evaluate x1 plus y1, in that case, we will consider the previous carry generated by the x0 and y0. And after that, we all the 3 bits and we will check whether there is any carry or not, or whether there is any sum or not. Now, if we design this truth table in a Carnot map, then we will get the following expression for the output carry and the sum. And the expression will look like this if we design it in a Carnot map. And if we want to design this equation in a digital circuit, then the overall circuit will look like this. Now, in this circuit, if we feed the input x and y, we will get the corresponding sum and carry. So now in this example, we will show you how to perform binary addition with the help of a full adder. Here we have considered 4-bit binary addition with the help of 4 full adders. Now, as we know that the full adder receives 3 inputs, 2 operand values and 1 carry. So here in this example, we have considered 2 operand A and B. So 4 bits of the operand A is A0, A1, A2, A3. And similarly, the 4 bits of the operand B is B0, B1, B2 and B3. And previously, carry is C0 equals to 0. Now, in a first full adder, it will receive the 0th bit of the A and B operand, so A0 and B0 respectively, and after that it will consider the previous carry C0, which is 0. Now, after adding them up, it will generate the first bit summation S0 and it will produce the carry C1. Now we will use the second full adder. The second full adder receives the first bit of the two operands A and B, which is A1 and B1, and after that it will do a addition A1 B1 plus C1, where C1 is the previously generated carry, and it will produce the summation for the first bit position S1, and it will produce the carry C2. Now we will again append a full adder before it, and this full adder will receive the second bit of the two operands A2 and B2, and after that it will also consider the C2 previously generated carry. So we will add A2, B2 and C2, and it will produce the summation for the second bit position S2, and it will produce a carry C3. Now we will append again another full adder in front of it. The fourth full adder will receive the third bit of the two operands A and B, which are A3 and B3 respectively. And after that we will add C3 with it. So it will be A3 plus B3 plus C3. It will produce the summation for the third bit position, which is S3, and it will also produce the final output carry, which is C4. Now, with the help of C4, S3, S2, S1, and S0, we will represent the binary addition result. Now, binary adder subtractor we can implement in a single circuit. Here, in this circuit, we can implement both the addition as well as the subtraction. Now, let us explain you how you can do that. So, first of all, you can see that the operand A and B are initially fed into the XOR. And all of you know that in a XOR, if one operand is 0, in that case, whatever be the operand in the second input, that will traverse to the output. But if one input to the XOR gate is 1, in that case, whatever be the other input, that will be complemented while traversing from the output. That means if in a XOR one input is 0, then other operand will traverse through the output. But if one operand is 1, in that case other operand will be complemented in the output of the XOR gate. And we have used the same logic for implementing the adder subtractor circuit. In this example, initially we have considered m equals to 0. When m equals to 0, the one operand of all the XOR gate will receive 0 value. So all the other operand B0 will traverse through the output of XOR gate. Similarly, B1, B2 and B3 also be the output of the XOR gate. So now full adder will receive A0, B0, A1, B1, A2, B2 and A3, B3 in a similar fashion. Similarly, we have connected the previous carry with the M signal. So if M is 0, the previous carry C0 will also be 0. Now, as you know that it is similar to the previous implementation of a binary adder, and with the help of this representation, we can easily get the binary summation with the help of C4, C4, S3, S2, S1 and S0. Now, how we can implement a subtraction with the help of this circuit. Now, suppose instead of making m to 0, if we turn on or if you make m value to 1, then it will perform the binary subtraction. How you can do that? As here m is 1, so one input of all XOR gate will be 1, and as all input to the all XOR gate is 1, so obviously the complemented value will be the output of all XOR gate. So here full adder will receive A0, B0 bar, A1, B1 bar, A2, B2 bar and A3, B3 bar. So they are receiving the complemented value of the operand B. Now again, as m is 1, so obviously C0 will also be 1. So it will look like this. It will look like m equals to nothing else but the a plus b bar minus plus 1. A plus b bar plus 1, which is nothing else but the a minus b. So here in this picture you can see this is how we can implement both the addition and subtraction with the help of this circuit. Now, binary adder subtractor, when we are performing, we need to know that whether there is any overflow or not. As in our previous class we have explained Then during the addition, if the generated result produce a negative result, while adding to negative number, if it produce some positive result, that means there is an overflow. Now, how a system or hardware can detect overflow or not? We just need to check the final carry, which is here C4, and the previous carry, which is C3, and we'll feed into the XOR gate. If the final carry and the previous final carry is the same, then there is no overflow and the arithmetic result is correct. But if the value differs, then obviously XOR will produce an outcome 1, and if the XOR outcome is 1, then the final carry and previous final carry is not matched, the final carry and the pre-final carry are not matching, that means there is definitely an overflow and the final arithmetic result is wrong. In this slide, we are going to show you how to implement binary decrementer or incrementer with the help of a half adder. So for that purpose, we have considered a register A, and it is a 4-bit register. So bit values are A0, A1, A2 and A3. Now, as we know that hardware half adder can receive only two inputs. So in the first case, the half adder will receive 1 as the input and it will be added with the A0th bit, and it will produce a summation S0, and whatever be the carry, that will propagate to the next half adder, and that carry will be added with the A1, the first bit of the A register. It will again generate a result S1, and it will again may generate some carry. Then that particular carry will be added with the value of A2, the second bit of the A register, and it will again generate the next summation, which is the second bit of a summation S2, and it will again generate a carry that will be added with the A3, and after that it will generate the third summation bit S3, and it will generate the final carry S4. So this is how you can implement a binary incrementer. In this picture, you can understand that it is nothing else but the A+1. Similarly, you can also implement binary decrementer only if you use 1 in all the bit position of Y instead of a single 1 and the carry. So in case of binary decrementer, you have to consider the all bit position of A register, A0, A1, A2, A3, and for the other input you need to consider 1 value, and in that way it will be A+1111, and A+1111 is nothing else but the A+2's complement of 1, which is nothing else but the A-1. And this is how you can implement the binary decrementer. This arithmetic circuit performs 4 distinct arithmetic operations, and the basic component of all of it is the parallel adder. The output of the binary adder is calculated from the following arithmetic sum, D equals to A plus Y plus Cin. With the help of a single circuit, we can perform all four binary operations. And here, for that purpose, we have considered 4-bit binary operations only. So as we have considered 4-bit binary operations, so that is why we have considered 4 multiplexers. All multiplexers are 4 cross 1 multiplexer. That means the multiplexer will receive 4 input and produce 1 output. As there are 4 input in the multiplexer, so there will be 2 selection line to select any one of the 4 inputs. And similarly, there will be 4 full adders. The full adder will, it is a full adder, it will have a 3 input port, and here you can see that there is a 2 input port X and Y. The Y will receive value through multiplexer, where X will receive value directly from the register. Here we have considered 2 register as the operand, A and B. A register operand values are A0, A1, A2, A3. So it is a 4-bit value. Similarly, B register has a 4-bit value. Values are B0, B1, B2 and B3. Now suppose you want to perform addition. Suppose for selection line 00, you are going to perform addition. So in case of addition, the selection line value will be 00. The Cin previously generated carry will be 0. So as the selection line is 00, so 0th bit from all the 4 masks will be selected. For the first mask, the 0th bit is B0. For the second mask, 0th bit is B1. For the third mask, the 0th bit is B2. And for the fourth mask, the 0th bit is B3. So obviously, the Y input port of all the full adder will receive the value from the B register actually, and it will perform A plus B because the below circuit is nothing else but the circuit performed for the binary addition as we have explained just previous slide. So similarly, if you want to perform the subtraction, then you need to select the selection line 01. If you select the selection line 01 and if you select the previous carry as 1, it will act as the subtractor. How? Because if you select the selection line 01, in that case the first bit of the all mask will be selected. Now the first bit of the first mask is B0 bar. For the second mask, the first bit is B1 bar. For the third mask, the 1th bit is the B2 bar, and for the fourth mask, the first bit is B3 bar. So all the mask output will produce the complement of the B register value, and which it will feed into the Y input port of the full adder. So the full adder will receive the value of B bar, and as it has already the value of A, and it will receive one value from the C in input port. So it full adder will have actually the value A plus B bar plus 1, and which is nothing else but the A minus B. So this is how this circuit can perform a binary subtraction operation. Similarly, if we consider the selection line 10, then it will consider the second bit of all multiplexers. Now the second bit of the all multiplexer, you can see it is 0. The second bit of the first multiplexer is 0. For the second multiplexer it is 0. For the third multiplexer it is 0. And for the fourth multiplexer it is also 0. So if you select the selection line as 10, and if you select the C in carry in the previous carry as 1, then it is nothing. The full adder will receive the value A plus 0 plus 1, and so which is actually A plus 1. So it is nothing else but the incrementer circuit. It will act as a binary incrementer. Similarly, if you select the selection line 11, then you can see that all multiplexer, the third bit position has a value 1. So if you select the selection line as 11, then Y input port of all the flip-flops will receive one value from the multiplexer. And other value is fixed with the value 1, A, fixed with the value A. And in this case also, C in carry in is 0. So if you consider this configuration, then it will be similar to A plus 1111 plus 0, and in 4 bit value 1 plus 1111 is nothing else but the 2's complement of 1. That means 1 plus that means 1111 is minus 1. So it will act as 1 it will act as A minus 1. And that is how it will act as a decrementer circuit. Like arithmetic operation, logical operation can also be performed in a digital computer. There are in general 4 types of logical operations. This is the symbol of OR operation, and this is the circuit of the OR gate. So we can perform a binary OR operation like this, as we have explained in this example. So it consider each binary bits and perform a OR operation between individual bits. So this is how we can represent OR operation in a RTL language. In the first left example, you can see that it is P plus Q colon R1 arrow R2 plus R3. So obviously R2 plus R3 is the addition operation. We will add the content of R2 and R3 register, and after that we copy the content into R1 register. But when we will copy or transfer this? When either of P or Q will have a value 1. So if either P or Q is 1, then we will perform the transfer. If both are 0, we will not transfer. So in case of conditional segment, we can use plus operator to denote the OR operation, but in case of register notation, we cannot represent plus sign. In that case, if we want to perform OR operation between two registers, we need to explicitly this sign to represent a binary OR operation. Here in this example, you can see R5 and R6, we are performing OR operation and storing the result in R4. Now the next logical operation is the AND operation. This is the symbol of AND operation and this is the AND gate. And now in this example, we can perform the AND operation between two binary strings. Here we need to consider each binary bit and perform bitwise the AND operations. Here in this example, P conjunction Q state the condition that both P and Q should be 1, and then only we will perform R2 and R3, and after ending that result, we will say copy or transfer the result into the R1 register. Now similarly, this is the complement operation and this is the gate for the complement operation. Complement operation will toggle or flip every bit position value of the binary string. XOR is another logical micro operation. So this is the symbol of XOR and this is the XOR gate. Now if we want to perform XOR operation between two binary strings, then we need to perform it bitwise. So if the two bit of the two operand of the XOR is same, in that case output will be 0. But if the two input to the XOR gate is differ, in that case output will be 1. So here in this example, you can see the rightmost 4 bits are identical. So that is why the results are 0. But in yellow ink, you can see the both operand value is different. The first operand value is 0 and the next operand value is 1. And that is why outcome is 1. Similarly, the most significant bit of the first operand and the most significant bit of the second operand is differs. And that is why the output of the XOR gate is 1 in case of MSB. Now with the help of this previous XOR AND OR gate, we can implement complex logical circuitry also, like set selective operation. It is used to force selected bit of a register into logic 1 by using OR operation. Suppose you want to set some bit of any bit position, you have to use the OR operation. So the bit suppose is 0100, and suppose you want to set the most significant bit to 1. So what you will do? You will do perform a OR operation with 1000. So as the you are performing a OR operation with 1000, it will set the most significant bit of the operand with 1 value. Similarly, selective complement operation can be done with the help of an XOR gate. So, it is used to force selected bits of a register to be complemented by using XOR operation. Suppose you have a bit position 0001. And if you want to just make the last least significant one as 0, and if you want to make the most significant bit 0 as 1, that means you want to complement the LSB and the MSB, you need to XOR it with the value 1001. So if you perform a XOR operation with 1001, it will set the most significant bit and it will clear the least significant bit LSB, and the overall representation will become 1000. Similarly, we can perform insertion operation with the help of fundamental logical operators. So first of all, here we need to perform some mask operation with the help of AND operator, and after that we need to perform OR operation with the desired value. Let us explain with an example. Suppose R1 register has a value 0110100, and we desire to replace the leftmost 4 bits, which is 0110, with the desired value 1000. Now how we can achieve that? So obviously, first of all, we will perform AND operation with the operand which has the first 4 leftmost bit with the value 0 and the last 4 bit of the rightmost position with the value 1. Now if we perform this operation, then it will clear the first 4 bit of the R1 register with the 0 values. Now after clearing the first 4 bit of the R1 register, we will perform a OR operation. In the OR operation, the operand we will consider 1100, which is the desired value for the first four leftmost bit of the register, and the next four bit is 0000. And if we do the OR operation, then it will set the first four leftmost bit of the R1 register with the desired value 1110. Now you can see the R1 register has a value 1110, the desired four bit values, and after that 1010. Similarly, NAND operation can be done with the help of AND and complement operator. This is how it basically achieves. First, it performs the AND operation between two binary strings, and after that it complement it. NOR operation similarly can be performed with the combination of OR and complement operator. So here in this example, you can see that firstly we OR the two binary strings, and after that we complement it. Similarly, the preset or set micro operation or clear micro operation can be done with the help of OR and AND gate respectively. Suppose we want to set some bit of some register, then all we need to use is a set of ones. Here in this example, the value of the register is 10110. Now if we OR it with the 1111, then it will set all the bits of the register with the value 1111. Similarly, if we want to reset or clear all the bits of the register, what we will do? We will just need to do an AND with the set of zeros. Here in this example, the value is 100110, and if we AND it with the 000000, then the final result will become 000000. That means we are resetting all the values of the register. Now, how we can implement these things in a hardware? So let us see how we can do that. Now, this is how we can implement this thing in a actual hardware. So here in this example, we have considered a 4 cross 1 multiplexer where 4 inputs are there and 1 output will be there. And as 4 input is there, we need log 4 base 2, 2 signal lines. Now here in this picture, you can see that the first 0th input to the multiplexer is the XOR operation between AI and BI, where the second input is the OR operation between AI and BI, the third input is the AND operation between AI and BI, and fourth input is the complement or NOT gate of on AI. So obviously, if we select the selection line 00, it will do the XOR operation between AI and BI. If we select 01, it will do a OR operation between AI and BI. If we select the selection line as 10, it will perform an AND operation between AI and BI. And if we consider the selection line as 11, it will perform the complement on AI. So it will toggle the value of AI. Similar to arithmetic and logical micro operation, we can also perform shift micro operation. It is used for serial transfer of data. It is also used in conjunction with arithmetic, logic and other data processing operations. The content of the register can be shifted to in the left direction or in the right direction. And in case of shifting, the first flip-flop receives the binary information from the serial input. Now there exist three kinds of shift micro operations. One is logical, second one is circular, and third one is the arithmetic. Now this is how shift operation actually implemented. Here you can see the serial input is the starting point. In case of right shift, we shift all the bit values in the register from the left position to the right position, and the most significant bit may be replaced with the zero bit. And similarly, in case of left shift, you can see the serial input is in the right end. And in this case, we shift all the bit from the right position to the left position. And the rightmost bit or LSB sometimes replaced with the value 0. Now let us explain logical left shift. Here in this example, we want to suppose logically left shift the content of the register R2 by 1 bit position. So here in this example, you can see we are shifting the content of the register R2 from the right hand side to the left hand side. So after this operation, the previous most significant bit of the R2 register will be lost, and the new content of LSB position in the R2 register will be 0. Similarly, for circular shift operation, no bit basically lost. It is a circular operation. So it circulates the bit of the register around two ends without loss of information. So in this example, we are showing you left shift, circular left shift operation. So it is written in a RTL language, R2 arrow SICIL R2 comma 1. So it will perform a 1-bit circular left shift operation. Here you can see that the previous MSB will go into the LSB position in the current value, and similarly MSB will become the LSB now, and the previous LSB will be the second LSB, where the next bit from the most significant bit will become the most significant bit now. Arithmetic shifts. Arithmetic shift is used to perform the signed binary left shift or right shift operations. If you perform a left shift operation by 1 bit, then it will multiply the number by 2. If we perform a 1 bit right shift, it will divide the number by 2. Now, during the left shift arithmetic operation, overflow may occur. So how we can detect overflow? So if we perform a 1-bit arithmetic left shift operation, and if it change the previous sign bit of the operand, then there is an overflow. Now let us explain how arithmetic shift happens. So in case of arithmetic right shift, the most significant bit stays as it is, it do not change, but all the bits including the most significant signed bit move 1-bit position right, and obviously after this overall shift, the previous least significant bit R0 will be lost because of this shift. And how the arithmetic left shift happen? Arithmetic left shift is similar to the logic left shift. In this case, all the bit from the R0 to Rn-1 shift 1-bit position from the right hand side to the left hand side. So obviously the previous most significant bit or the signed bit is removed by the next most significant bit. And obviously as the last least significant bit R0 is occupied with the zero value. Now in this example you can observe that in arithmetic left shift the most significant bit is replaced by the next most significant bit, and if there is a bit change between the most significant bit and the next most significant bit, then obviously there is an overflow during arithmetic left shift operation. Overflow may occur during arithmetic left shift operation. Now how can we detect there is an overflow or not? So in this case also we'll use the XOR gate, and in the XOR gate we'll feed the most significant bit and the next most significant bit to it, and if the output is zero, that means if the most significant bit and the next most significant bit are identical, in that case there will be no overflow. But if the most significant bit and the next most significant bit differs, in that case XOR output will be 1, and we can state that there is an overflow. Here in this example, we are going to explain all the shift operations. For that purpose, we have considered a register R1 with the value 1100000. Now, firstly, we will explain the 1-bit right shift operation. In case of 1-bit right shift operation, you can observe the most significant bit will be as it is, and all other bits, including the most significant bit, will be moved from the left to the right position by 1 bit, and that is why the current updated value will be 1 followed by 1100000. But if we perform 1-bit arithmetic left shift operation, in that case all the bits will be moved from the right to left position by 1 bit. So previously generated most significant bit will be discarded, and the newly vacant LSB position will be filled by the 0 value. In case of 1-bit logical right shift operation, the signed bit will not be preserved. In that case, all bit will be shifted from the left position to the right position, and previous LSB will be rejected, and the most significant bit position will be filled with the 0 value. In case of 1-bit logical left shift operation, all bit will be shifted from the right direction to the left direction by 1 bit, and the previous MSB will be discarded, and the LSB position will be filled by the value 0. In case of circular right shift, what will happen? The bit positions will be circularly rotated. So in this particular case, the LSB, previous LSB will come into the MSB position, and all the bit will be shifted to the right direction by one bit. Similarly, in case of 1-bit left shift operation, all bit will be moved from the right direction to the left direction in a circular manner. And in this case, the previous MSB will go into the LSB part and will become the LSB now. Now, a shift unit could be implemented with the bidirectional shift register with the parallel load, but it has few drawbacks. First, it has two pulses, one for the clock and another for the shift signal. And it is not in an efficient processor unit where multiple number of registers share a common bus. So, it is better to use with the help of a combinatorial circuit. Now, this is how we can implement a left shift or right shift operation in a computer hardware. Now, here also we have considered a 4-bit register A. The bits values are A0, A1, A2 and A3. Now, you have here, as there are 4 bits, we have considered 4 multiplexer. But here you can notice that the multiplexer is 2 plus 1 multiplexer. So, there will be 2 input and 1 output. And as there are 2 inputs, so selection line log T/2 is 1. Now, if the selection line is 0, we will perform the shift right operation. If the selection line is 1, we will perform the shift left operation. Now, let us explain how it will work. Now, if we make the selection line 0, then you can notice then the 0th bit of the all mask will be selected. Now, in case of right shift, you can notice that the first, last mask will receive, last mask will receive the A1 value, and the second mask will receive the value of A2, and similarly the third mask will receive the value of A3, and the first mask will receive the value from the serial input IR. It can be 0, or it may be 0, or it can be any other value. Similarly, if we consider 1 for the selection line, then in case of that, the last mask will receive the serial input from IL. It may be 0, or it may be other value. And similarly, the second mask will receive the value of A0, the third mask will receive the value of A1, and the fourth mask will receive the value of A2, and obviously A3 value will be lost in that case. So this is how we can implement shift operation in a real hardware. Now, individual register can perform this micro operation directly, but it will make the circuit very complex and tedious to analysis. So that is why it is better to connect the set of register with a common operational unit, which is here is the ALU. Here we will implement a single unit which is called arithmetic logic shift unit that will perform all the operations. Now here you can observe there are 4 selection lines from S0 to S3. Now when S2 S3 will be 00, we will perform the arithmetic operation. When it will be 01, we will perform the logical operations. And when it will be 10 or 11, we will perform the shift operations. Now here suppose we first set the S2 and S3 value as 00. That means it should be deal with the arithmetic operations. Now in that particular fixed state, we will observe the S0 S1 value. When the S0 S1 will be 00, we will perform the addition. When it will be 01, we will perform the subtraction. When it will be 10, we will perform the increment. And when it will be 11, we will perform the decrement operation. Now, again, suppose the S2 S3 value is 01. In that case, we need to do the logical operations. That in that particular fixed state, we will observe the, again the S0 S1 value. If it is 00, in that case, we will perform the XOR operation. If it is 01, we will perform the OR operation. If it is 10, we will perform the AND operation. If it is 11, we will perform the NOT operation. Similarly, if the S2 S3 is 10, we will perform the right shift operation, and if the S2 S3 is 11, we will perform the left shift operation.